Hi, this video is on frequency tables, and the purpose here, what we want to do is graph qualitative data. But often before we graph the data, we will make a frequency table. So we're going to talk about what frequency means, relative frequency, and cumulative frequency. If you need this worksheet, you can get it on my website at caroleemath.com. And let's look at an example here. So we have a movie review website. And they're listing the number of stars that a movie has and how many of each. So on their website, they have 8 5-star films, 19 4-star films, 12 3-stars, 7 with 2 stars, and 4 with 1 stars. 1 star. And so here's a frequency table. We've got the categories. This is qualitative or categorical. So we have the categories listed here. And then the number of each, and these should match, so 8, 19, 12, 7, and 4. Okay, so it matches. Great, we can tell that 19 were 4-star films, but it's a little hard to know relatively how much is that. So a relative frequency is a percentage, and that really helps us to understand better how many of the films were 4-star films. So to get the percentage, first we need to know the total, how many films there were. So I'm just going to punch these in. 8 plus 19 plus 12 plus 7 plus 4. 50 films. Okay. 50 total. So then to get the percentage here, we need to take 8 out of 50. And see what that is. 16%. Just a reminder that when we're switching from a decimal to a percent, we're going to move the decimal over 2 places. Okay, so then 19 out of 50. I'll just write all these. 12 out of 50. 7 out of 50. And 4 out of 50. If you want to just go ahead and do them, you can just pause the video and start it again or skip ahead. 19 out of 50 is 38%. Is 24%. There's a cool pattern going on here because it's 50. Because it's out of 50, we're doubling the number. Did you notice that? So this should be 14, and this should be 8%, because 4 out of 50 is equal to 8 out of 100. So kind of a cool pattern there. That is our relative frequency. And that, now it's a little easier to understand. Okay, 38% of the films were 4-star films. It's easier for me to comprehend and understand what that means relative to the other categories of stars than just 19 or even 19 out of 50. So that's why relative frequency is useful. Now, cumulative frequency, we are going to accumulate them. We're going to add them together, and at the bottom we should have 100%. So the way this works for cumulative, we're going to start with 16%. We have 16% in the first category. And then each time we're going to add on. So we're going to add the 16 plus 38, and that's 54%. So we're going to add that together. Then we're going to add the 24, which is 78%, plus 14 is 92%. And you can see if you add 8, we get 100%. So cumulative means we're adding on from the previous categories, and then by the end, we should have 100%, or something's wrong. One thing that could be tricky is round off error. These were really nice numbers and they all came out to an even percentage. What if it was like 16.2% or 16.253217? We would have to round, and so we might end up with some round off error, and this might be not exactly 100%. We would just have to decide based on our context and our data where we wanted to round our frequencies to. Okay, so that is frequency, relative frequency, and cumulative frequency, and we will look at how to graph this in another video. So thanks for watching.